Good morning, students. In today's session, we are going to start with chapter 7 of typography, and chapter name is computer virus. Now, what is virus? A computer virus is a software program attached to a legitimate program that is destructive in nature and infects other program in the system by replicating and attaching itself to other healthy program. These harm the computer in many ways. It means it is also a computer software program which automatically attached with your other software programs, and it will try to replicate and attach itself to other healthy programs. And always it is harmful for your computer system, for your file data, or for other operating system part. Now, what are the harmful features of computer virus? It can corrupt and delete the data and file. It can affect the functionality of computer software application part. It can affect the hard disk part by deleting data. It means erasing everything. It can be attached to use the email, and email is affected to the other computer. The processing of computer is getting also slow. It will also affected. The virus also spreads through the file downloaded on the internet, and the virus can't affect write protected disks or write written document, already compressed file and computer hardware. It only infect the software part. Any time hardware part will not be affected with the virus, every time the part of software will be affected with the virus part. Now, what is the objective of this chapter? After learning this chapter, you will be able to understand to define computer virus and its evolution, to differentiate between computer virus and biological virus, to identify the different type of viruses with their name and area of infection, to explain the damage done by the virus, the process to virus infection, the effect of virus on operating system, and to apply virus prevention measures. So let's start with topic computer virus. A computer virus is a small program which can attach it or infect the other program as well as replicate itself within the knowledge of user, like its biological counterpart, and run against user wishes. It means whatsoever user want to do, it will do the processing of opposite work it will start. All computer viruses are man-made. Most widespread virus infection spread through email message attachment. Every time it happens, when we are going to open an email and we get it download in our computer system, save it, the virus will also be saved on your computer system that activate when we open. And internet is the main region of virus infection in the computer system. And virus full form is vital information resource under siege. And this concept is not new, but dates back to 1949 when John von Neumann introduced the concept of self-replicating program. In general, it was used as a program, but afterward it got converted into the virus part. The first commercial application virus appeared in 1985. That was dealt by two Pakistani brothers in order to keep track of software piracy. Used brain virus, also known as Pakistani virus, on their low-cost software. It was an extra program not supplied by the original manufacturer. These type of self-replicating program multiplied so fast, and they are a threat to smooth the operation of computer system. Now, computer and biological virus. Computer virus is an electronic virus, and biological virus are tiny genetic codes that are DNA or RNA that take over the machinery of a living cell and are capable of making thousands of replicas of the original virus, duplicate copies. Like biological virus, the computer virus carries in it an instructional code that make copies of itself. In computer, the virus take temporary control of disk of operating system and when it come in contact with uninfected computer, the virus passes on the uninfected computer also. It is assumed that biological virus and computer virus are same entity because both cause infection and damage to their host or target. Although some of their features and characteristics are same, but they are quite different from each other. Now, computer virus classification. Computer virus can be classified in many types of categories, and that is first one, boot sector virus. It is a type of virus which infect master boot record of your hard disk. It directly affect on your hard disk part. The infected code run when the system is booted. When your system is getting started, it start booting from infected disk. They infect at a BIOS level. BIOS means basic input output system level. They use DOS command to spread to other floppy disk. DOS commands are used to run the program, and these commands are used by the virus system to explore its effect on other file. Since the floppy disk are not used, the propagation of boot sector virus has got most over. After the introduction of boot sector safeguard with the operating system, it is not possible for boot sector virus to infect the computer. It means the antivirus for boot sector virus is boot sector safeguard. If you are having boot sector safeguard, then there will be no any effect of boot sector virus, and their hard disk will be your hard disk will be safe, and it will not create the bad sectors in your hard disk. The computer is infected by the virus, this virus only if the virus is used to boot up the system. After completing the booting of system and running of operating system, the virus can't affect the system. An example are Polyboot, Gravity. These are the option. These are the virus types that are affected like boot sector virus. Second is companion virus. Unlike traditional viruses, a companion virus is computer virus which doesn't modify any file. Instead, it creates copy of the file and place a different extension on it. Like you have saved the file with abc.doc, it will create .txt, .binary, .exe, multiple file it will create with different extension, usually .com. And this make a companion virus difficult to detect, as antivirus software tend to use change in the file as clue. The companion virus is an older version of virus that was more prominent during MS-DOS. It needs human intervention to further infect a computer, but also after the advent of Windows XP, there was no use of MS-DOS, so there are fewer ways for this type of virus to propagate itself. And some examples are Stater, email virus that enters your system through email when you are getting to open the email. An email virus is a virus which is attached to an email communication or sent with it. Many different types of email virus work on different ways. There are also a variety of methods used to contract such challenging cyber attacks. Email virus also vary in many ways. In some cases, the sender of an email virus may be unknown to a user, or a subject line may be filled with a silly text. In some case, a hacker may cleverly distinguish the mail as being from a known and trusted sender. It enters through email only. It can be entered through text. It can be entered through a hacker also. Logic bomb virus, logic bomb and time bomb are small malicious program to cause harm at a certain point of time, but they don't replicate. They are not even program in their own right, but rather segment of other programs. A logic bomb may be implemented by someone trying to sabotage a database when they are fairly certain they wouldn't be present to experience the effect, such as full database deletion. These such type of virus are directly affected to delete the big number of records in the form of database. In these instances, logic bomb virus are programmed to extract revenge or sabotage work. For example, a programmer could delete the critical session of code by establishing a logic bomb if he or she is terminated from the company. And logic bomb are most commonly installed by the insider who have the access to the system. Next is macrovirus. Macrovirus that will enter in the form of database file or document file or PowerPoint file or Excel file. A Mac virus which spread to other computer through software program that utilize macros, where we can create the macros. And these virus affect the file created using some applications that contains macros such as DOC, PPS, Excel or MSSS database. For example, Microsoft Office and Excel are two popular and widely used programs which have the capability of executing macros. So the macro virus is initially embedded into one document or few document, but it can spread to the other document within the same computer, as well as reaching out to the other computer through shared document and infect the other files also. An example of macro virus is Relax. They usually fix themselves inside the computer memory and get activated during the start of operating system and end up infected other open files, and they are hidden in RAM. Next is cross-site scripting virus. It is also called as XSS. Cross-site scripting, it is an injection attack which is carried out on web application that accept input but do not properly separate data and executable code before the input is delivered back to the user browser. It mostly use the vulnerable website as a vehicle to deliver a malicious script to the victim browser. And during the page loading, the malicious script execute, making the user unable to avoid the attack. And the best example is JavaScript. This type of virus enter in the computer system when we are going to start the coding section of program. Next is worm virus. Worm virus is very similar to a virus and has the ability to self-replicate itself and infect the computer also. They travel longer distance by storing themselves in critical area of disk, from where they get loaded and have with them sufficient code to transfer themselves outward from the infected system. Worm have been also known to damage and infect the entire LAN. These are directly affected with the network area. It doesn't modify a program like a virus. However, it replicates so much that it consumes the resources of computer and make it slow. And the example of worm are Loggit, Nimbra. Next is Trojan Horse. It is most harmful virus. It is similar to the virus. Trojan Horse is hidden in a hidden malicious code that could alter and delete the information of client computer or perform any other unauthorized function. And Trojan Horse contains program that corrupt the data or damage the files. It can also corrupt the software application, and Trojans can illegally trace important logic details of user online, for example e-banking. And the activities of Trojans are deleting the data, blocking data, modifying data, copy data, or disrupting the performance of computer. It means slow down the process of computer. Trojan horse doesn't replicate themselves like virus and don't infect other softwares. The difference between bump and Trojan is that the bump is insider job and Trojan are brought in from outside by unsuspected user through other program. In this session we have covered different type of computer viruses. Next session we will cover the next part. Thank you. Have a nice day.